Episode number 55. Porthos succeeded him, and thanks to one of those disappearances to which he was accustomed, he was able to provide for the wants of all for a fortnight. At last it became Aramis's turn, who performed it with a good grace, and who succeeded, as he said, by selling some theological books, in procuring a few pistols. Then, as they had been accustomed to do, they had recourse to M. de Tréville, who made some advances on their pay, but these advances could not go far with three musketeers, who were already much in arrears, and a guardsman, who as yet had no pay at all. At length, when they found they were likely to be really in want, they got together, as a last effort, 8 or 10 pistols, with which Porthos went to the gaming table. Unfortunately, he was in a bad vein. He lost all, together with 25 pistols for which he had given his word. Then the inconvenience became distress. The hungry friends, followed by the lackeys, were seen hunting the keys and guard rooms, picking up among their friends abroad all the dinners they could meet with, for according to the advice of Aramis, it was prudent to sow repasts right and left in prosperity, in order to reap a few in time of need. Athos was invited 4 times, and each time took his friends and the lackeys with him. Porthos had 6 occasions, and contrived in the same manner that his friends should partake of them. Aramis had 8 of them. He was a man, as must have been already perceived, who made but little noise, and yet was much sought after. As to D'Artagnan, who as yet knew nobody in the capital, he only found 1 chocolate breakfast at the house of a priest of his own province, and 1 dinner at the house of a cornet of the guards. He took his army to the priests, where they divided as much provision as would have lasted him for 2 months, and to the cornets, who performed wonders, but as Planchet said, people do not eat at once for all time, even when they eat a good deal. D'Artagnan thus felt himself humiliated in having only procured 1.5 meals for his companions, as the breakfast at the priests could only be counted as half a repast, in return for the feasts, which Athos, Porthos, and Aramis had procured him. He fancied himself a burden to the society, forgetting in his perfectly juvenile good faith that he had fed this society for a month, and he set his mind actively to work. He reflected that this coalition of 4 young, brave, enterprising, and active men ought to have some other object than swaggering walks, fencing lessons, and practical jokes, more or less witty. In fact, 4 men, such as they were, 4 men devoted to one another, from their purses to their lives, 4 men always supporting one another, never yielding, executing singly, or together the resolutions formed in common, 4 arms threatening the 4 cardinal points, or turning toward a single point, most inevitably, either subterraneously, in open day, by mining, in the trench, by cunning, or by force, open themselves a way towards the object they wish to attain, however well it might be defended, or however distant it may seem. The only thing that astonished D'Artagnan was that his friends had never thought of this.